I'm unapologetic about calling myself a natural born freak.
She's a former swimming Paralympian international circus star. She's got a degree in politics and she's done all that with no eyesight. Now a pro acrobat, the woman you're about to meet is a self-described freak show. Sarah Houbolt is her name and she's on a controversial mission.
Sarah Houbolt, hi.
Hi, it's nice to meet you.
You are a very rare breed of human, Sarah.
Yeah, so I have a rare condition called Hallerman Streiff Syndrome. I am only one of 200 in the world. It affects my hair. My hair just never grew. I was born totally blind and now I'm legally blind, but you wouldn't really know it because I tend to just walk around the world quite functional.
Now, you are a self-described freak show.
Yeah.
What does that mean exactly?
So I'm a natural born freak. That's what I am. It's a really positive identification. It is an identification that really only people with disability can use. Because natural born freak is being born unique. It's being born different, visibly different, sensorily different, and it comes from the old freak shows from, you know, 200 years ago.
Here, hurry, step this way, the strangest sight from the island.
Back in the 16th century, freak shows became a thing. In a nutshell, they were all about putting people with deformities up as entertainment, and massive crowds started paying to laugh at others' misfortune. But fast forward to the new millennium, and freak shows now, although still popular, are pretty controversial.
The freak shows were actually the safest place for people with disability to be. If you were not in the freak shows, you were subjected to so many more inequalities and situations of abuse. There were the ugly laws, anti-marriage laws, compulsory sterilisation for women with disability, institutional living. So all of these structural inequalities that told society that people with disability were not worth having around.
Surely there'd be some people who may take offence to you describing yourself as a freak show, particularly other people with disabilities. Mm-hmm. Have you ever really pissed anyone off?
When I started training in circus, I had the disability sector go, "How dare you do circus?" because of the history of the freak shows. And that made me really upset. I'm unapologetic about calling myself a natural born freak. I want to do freak show work. I want to do sideshow work. And also I kind of like the pain of the bed of nails and really seeing what my body can do. I like putting a nail up my nose. I enjoy it. I can show you. Shall we do it?
I don't know why I'm doing this.
You can do it.
Okay.
Ready? We can do it together.
Oh, that feels so weird. It's going in my nose. Oh. Oh my God, that feels so weird. Is it meant to feel weird?
Yes.
I feel sick in the stomach. Okay, I'm taking it out. Oh, that feels so weird.
Yeah.
Why on earth would that be enjoyable?
It's intriguing. It's science. A lot of the stuff about sideshow is not what my body looks like, but what my body can do.
And there's not much that Sarah's body can't do. After competing at the Sydney Paralympic Games in 2000 as a vision-impaired swimmer, Sarah swapped the water for air. She began training as an acrobat and sideshow circus star and has been performing blind, under the big top and on film all over the world since.
How the hell do you swing about up there without being able to see what you're doing? That's incredible.
I think I have an advantage in that I don't see how high I am, so the fear is not so much there. And really when you're swinging around on something, you're always touching something. So my sense of feeling is prioritised over my sense of vision. I think it's really counterintuitive in the arts to think that you need eyesight to do physical performance. That's not right, that's wrong.
So how do you feel when you're up there?
I feel activated. I feel like I can feel my whole body. It's an intense feeling because my sense of touch is so strong. I'm quite hypersensitive in terms of my touch because I've learnt how to use my skin as my eyes. It can be a really intense experience. I can often read things quicker than other people realise.
What scares you the most in life?
Look, I'm fine with physical danger. I think falling in love is the most dangerous thing.
Oh. Wow, do tell.
Yeah, no.
Do tell.
Nope, too dangerous.
Are you falling in love right now, Sarah?
Not answering. Ultimately, I'm the most scared of being alone because of the experiences I've had in this lifetime. And I just think no one should be alone.
I think it'd be incredibly difficult for you to be alone because you're lovely to talk to. It's been an absolute pleasure. Thank you so much.
Yeah, no worries. Thank you.